Hi Gemini, welcome to my channel, and today we are doing your February general reading. This is for the star sign of Gemini, so you could be a Gemini Sun, Moon, Rising, Jupiter, or Venus. Also, please check out MinervaTarot.com if you're looking for a discounted reading, because the prices have been, it's now one flat price for any booking that you choose. And that's going to stay till July. Yay! You heard it correct. Till July, same rate, single pricing for any reading that you choose. So Gemini, feel free if you have been planning your personal reading or planning to give somebody a reading on Valentine's Day, feel free to look around. All right, so now to your general readings. Let's see what's there, what's coming for you. And also, Mercury is going retrograde this month, and guys, especially, it's going to be heavy for you, Geminis, I know. There you are. All right, very powerful. All right, Gemini, your underlying energy is of the Nine of Pentacles. So it is about making money. You want to make money. You want to be rich. You want to have money in your hand. It's all about wealth. Yeah. Partnership, love. Love comes. Well, money is important. Love can follow, but I need both. I think my money is going to get me a good partner, or I'm going to be happy in my love life only if I have a good pocket. Okay? All right, so what is happening with you, Geminis? Firstly, in your current situation, I think wherever you're working or wherever, even in your family or in your surrounding, you're finding that respect that you have been missing for so long. So you're getting that name, fame, recognition. People want to work in a team with you. Your team is good. They appreciate you. You appreciate them. There's mutual appreciation. People recognize you for your efforts. But where's the challenge then? The challenge is authority. The challenge could be a Leo. Could be a person, your boss. It is about the higher-ups, the officials. There is something about authority. Maybe their policies and your thought process don't match. Or maybe you're losing patience. It's like it's testing your patience. Everything is fine, but you are looking for, it's not only verbal value and verbal recognition and fame that you're looking for. It is also about material gains. Maybe there is where you're kind of taming yourself. Maybe the money isn't good. Or maybe something is with the authorities, which you find you don't have an authority, or you don't have much say, or you want to have authority, they're not giving it to you. You can do much better, but they're kind of not allowing you, okay? That's the kind of vibe that I'm getting here with this in the objection position. So what you have to do this month, Gemini, firstly, move on. Six of Swords, move on. If things are not working in your favor, if you feel all these rewards, recognitions, or name, these are all verbal things, they're just carrots, but carrots hanging in front of you, but you don't have any monetary gain, or people, financial gains and material gains, and there is problem with the authority, you have two options. Either you quit, you go to a different place, or you start overlooking. So that is your advice here. Move on. So either you stop focusing on it and keep doing what you're doing, or if you want to focus on it, then change the job, change the place. But don't stick onto it. Don't carry it with you, because it's not serving you anything. Okay? Now, what you have to stop doing or stop focusing on this month is on your wishes. Maybe you had a lot of dreams, a lot of wishes along with this. Because you thought, you're getting the reward and recognition, you're getting name fame, but you wanted material along with it. You wanted money. You needed name fame and money. But name, fame has come, money isn't coming. But it's about your wishes, okay? It's about, I got to be here because I need to make money. I have to be here. This is like the Nine of Cups. It's about your wish fulfillment. Maybe there's an option. There's an option. You can leave that thing behind. Even in relationship, maybe these people, they give you a lot of recognition. They understand your importance, but they drain you. They drain you. You have to kind of hold your patience. You just cannot deal with them. You don't have the patience to deal with those people. But somewhere you have some kind of wishes attached to whichever group, whichever organization, whichever people you're associating yourself with. There are certain wishes attached to it. You wanted to get those things out. So it's like I've come so far. I might as well stick for some more time and get what I wanted to get out of this relation or out of this organization or out of this place. So don't focus on that. That is not happening. If there is a challenge with authority, if there is a challenge within yourself, you are conflicting yourself, you may not be able to fulfill your wishes. So it's time you move on. Leave those things behind. And just focus on new things, okay? Because what is coming towards you is a beautiful energy of temperance, balance. This is what you need to reach. It's not always about wishes. I want this. It is not about wishes. Sometimes you have to let go of your wishes and take what is coming, what is given to you by the universe, instead of going in for what you wanted to manifest. Okay? Because sometimes we don't realize we want to manifest something which may not be good for us. So the universe steps in and gives us something else and we are never happy. We push that aside and we move towards the thing again that we want to achieve. So this is not the month for it, okay? You need to reach balance. You need to understand sometimes it is important for us to leave certain things, to move on from certain things, to get good things coming in our way, okay? To release certain things. It is not about wishes. It is not about I've done so much because I really wanted this. Now that it's here, it's not good. I cannot throw it away. Stop that mentality. You worked hard for it, it came to you, but after you've taken it in your hand, you realize it wasn't really worth all the effort, you can release it. Move on to the next thing. Because strike a balance between your mental peace and your physical vitality. That is what is coming towards you. A balance between your needs and wants, your wishes and your grants, okay? What is achievable and what is not achievable. You're going to come to a consensus by the end of February, I feel. Okay, so let's see what could be a bit uncomfortable for you and what could be good for you this month. So what is uncomfortable for Gemini this month? Libra and Capricorn. And what could be good for you this month is the 7th house and Jupiter. Okay, so Gemini, this month, if you're dealing with a Libra, this could be a bit difficult relationship. Because Libra is your fellow air sign, but it is the sign of balance. This is what is missing in you at this point of time. This will come towards you by the end of the month. But because you're not in balance, so you might find it difficult to deal with the diplomacy or the balance that a Libra gives. Maybe there is something in your team or maybe your boss or somebody who is a Libran and they're very balanced. They never react. They're always smiling. So you fail to understand why they are like that. And maybe you question them and you don't get concrete answers. So those could be challenging for you, okay? They could be frustrating you. So Libra or your 5th house could be a challenge for you. If you're a Gemini ascending, then Libra becomes your natural 5th house. So 5th house or the house of romance, partnership, creativity could be a challenge for you. Also, Capricorn is a challenge for you this month. So a hardworking Capricorn who doesn't care what the result is, they just keep working, working, working. They're like the woodpecker. They keep pecking the wood. They don't care. Okay? So they don't ask questions. They just keep working. That's the typical Saturn energy. not very good in communication, and you are ruled by Mercury. You love communicating. You love doing two things at a time, multitasking. And Capricorn hates multitasking. They'll stick to one. So your authority or people you're dealing with could have Libra and Capricorn. You might find it difficult to be with them this month. What is good for you this month is your seventh house of partnership. If you want to form new partnerships, or if you're married, or if you're in a committed relationship, that house will go good. If you're looking for business partners or partners to start a business or to get married or to settle down, this would be a good house. Dealing with people to get your work done in partnership is a very good time. February is the time for that. So you will have a good Valentine's Day, if I'm not mistaken. Also, Jupiter is a good planet for you to work, because Jupiter is all about knowledge. Mercury is intelligence. It's not knowledge. Knowledge is Jupiter. So Jupiter is your confidence. Jupiter is your knowledge. Jupiter is your belief. And Jupiter is also the significator for your luck. So focus on Jupiter. If you have a strong Jupiter, see where Jupiter is in your natal chart and work on that house. That'll give you confidence. See how strong Jupiter is. And if you want to know all those details, astrological readings are available. You can check out Minerva Tarot, get your astrovedic chart done, and then understand your Jupiter. But if you know where your Jupiter is and how strong it is, or whether it's strong or weak, work with Jupiter. Okay? Work with knowledge. See where Jupiter is and see how strong it is. Work with those houses. Those will be good for you this month. All right? Okay, so this was your general reading for the month of February. I'll see you around with your other readings. Till then, take care, and also check out Minerva Tarot if you want any personal reading. And I'll see you around. Bye.